Commissioners, thank you for the opportunity to be here to pray with you all, guests and everyone else present. Let's take a moment to pray. Father, I thank you for this day. You are the loving and gracious God. You are indeed the giver of all good gifts. And we thank you for your many blessings. We especially thank you for your community leaders and their willingness to serve the people of this community. We ask that you bless them abundantly with your wisdom, guidance, courage, and strength. Be with them in their discussions and help them to be wise in the decisions that they make for the good of all those who have placed their trust and confidence in their leadership. Lord, grant them insight to lead with integrity and that their decisions reflect what is right and good. Keep them from short-sightedness and pettiness. Help them to make decisions that are for the good of all and guard them from blind self-interest. Dear Lord, grant them the humility to always seek your will in all that they do and say. Father, you truly are a great and awesome God, worthy to be praised. To you be all glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you. Have the Pledge of Allegiance, please.
Pledge of Allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, call to order the election board. Minutes from April 11th. Any changes or comments or corrections? Motion to approve the minutes?
So moved.
Second. All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Any public comment on the agenda for the election board as it stands? Update on preparation for municipal primary election.
All right. First of all, today was the last day for applications for absentee ballots. They needed to be turned in today. Starting tomorrow, the office will accept emergency absentee ballots. Emergency absentee ballots will be taken through 5 p.m. on Friday. It is required that they're notarized. You cannot have known before today or that you needed an absentee ballot. If you knew prior to, then it's not acceptable to get an emergency ballot. If something happens after that, then we also have emergency ballots from 5 p.m. Friday through Tuesday. In the event that an elector needs one of those, they must have the judge's approval to get an absentee ballot. Wanted to let everyone know that regular voted ballots are due by 5 p.m. on Friday. So absentee ballots, yes. And just as an aside, I'm told that we have approximately 280 absentee ballots out, which is average for municipal elections. We're doing a public test on Friday at 9 a.m. The public is welcome to attend, and that will be advertised in the newspaper.
Where is it?
It will be in the basement of the courthouse. And just as an aside, we did election night return testing last Friday. That is where we make sure that the county computer and the state's computers are communicating so that on election night everything is going through as it should and everything worked as it was supposed to. So.
Okay, thank you. How about poll workers? We're good?
We are all set on poll workers, I believe. Correct, Abby?
Yes.
Any other comments, questions? Any other business for the election board? Public comment for the election board? Have a motion to adjourn the election board?
So moved.
Second.
Second.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Adjourn the election board, call order the retirement board. Minutes, April 11th. Any changes or comments or questions? Motion to accept the minutes? And second?
Second.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Any public comment on retirement board agenda as it stands? Jill.
Requesting approval for the retirement board is presented on attachment A. Please note that we have 5 employees entering in our retirement fund.
Questions for Jill? Motion to approve the items?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Also requesting the ratification of the pension estimator software. This is a software that will allow us to in-house run pension estimates for a better service to our employees at a lesser cost to the county. The cost of the software is $7,500 with a professional maintenance fee of $750 per year starting 2018. This was also reviewed by Rich.
And how do we usually do the estimates?
This gets sent to our actuary, who then charges us $50 per quote, and it can take anywhere up to 2 weeks. This in-house software, we could have it, depending on the what's going on in the office, we can have it almost instantly for our employees.
And the typical payout, as far as cost is $7,500, that'll be up in...
That's a one-time fee for the software, and then the $750 is just a...
About a third of that.
Right, correct.
Per year to the third party that we're using now, so...
That is correct.
A three-year payout.
Correct, Commissioner.
Okay. Any other comments? Motion to ratify the estimator software?
I'll make that motion.
Second? All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there any other business for the retirement board? Any public comment for the retirement board? Have a motion to adjourn retirement board?
Make that motion.
In second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Adjourn retirement board, call it order the salary board. Minutes, April 11th. Questions, comments? Motion to approve minutes?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor? Thank you. Public comment on the salary board agenda as it stands. Salary board items for consideration, Jill.
Requesting approval for the salary board items on attachment B. We have some abolishment and creating of positions. Some are temporaries for the summer, some are internships as well.
Questions? Motion to approve the items? In second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Any other business for the salary board? Any public comment for the salary board? Have a motion to adjourn salary board?
So moved.
In second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Adjourn salary board, call it order the commissioner board. Any amendments to the board agenda as it stands? Yes, Jane?
Yes, Commissioners, under continuation agreements, I would like to add a contract for Julie Lagulin for a variety of therapy services. Under other items, I would like to add a HIPAA agreement with Community Connections for Care. And I would also like to observe that item three under other items should reflect that it is a ratification of the contract versus an approval.
Okay. Any other amendments to the board agenda as it stands? Have a motion to amend the commissioner board agenda as noted?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Minutes, April 11th. Any questions, comments, changes? Have a motion to approve minutes from April 11th?
So moved.
In second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Public comment on the commissioner board agenda as it stands. Board Administration, Mr. Doctor, you want to explain us why you're here?
So I'm here, Commissioner. Looking for your approval, your public approval on the PCCD grant application, Court Supervision Safety Initiative. It's for $10,000 state match free money to purchase body armor, mobile and portable radios for the probation officers while they're in the field.
Any questions? Motion to approve the grant?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you. Community Services. Bill, go first.
Good evening, gentlemen. I've got one item for ratification this evening, which is a request to submit an amendment for an existing grant for the runway pavement markings project. Total amount of the amendment is $8,713.90. Our local share is $218.90.
Can we meet with Bill and also Mr. Dunkel Monday morning before this meeting? And go over these contracts and other items, and it's a public workshop meeting. Everyone's invited to be there. Any questions? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.
Good evening, Commissioners. This evening I have two approvals and a ratification. The first approval is with Emerson Network Power
Questions? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Second approval is resolution 2017-08, designation of an agent. FEMA has requested that we change the agent, the previous agent for a disaster grant that we incurred in 2013, since he's no longer employed with the county, and add me as the new agent.
Questions? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Third is the ratification of the Motorola agreement for the CAD project that we are working with Mercer, Butler, and Lawrence Counties. Along with the ratification, Motorola has asked that we submit a letter with the following verbiage. Benega County has approved the contract with Motorola Solutions in the amount of $513,345. Furthermore, the county confirms that funding has been made available for the purchase of the system, which is $3,437,461, and all of the maintenance and support services of $2,175,884. As approved at the Commissioners Board meeting on May 9, 2017, the county does not issue purchase orders, and this letter acts as the only proof of funding for contract number 16-219241.
Okay. Any questions? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Thank you.
Thank you. Gonna rehearse next time, Tim, okay? You don't want the finance manager bumping you when you're saying numbers and stuff. Human Services, Jane.
Commissioners, I ask for your approval of the items outlined on attachment C, along with the two items that I just added to the agenda. There are quite a few, but they are all routine in nature. We are just in the process of presenting our contracts to move us into fiscal year 17-18.
And we have a meeting with Jane, a public workshop the morning of this meeting. 10 a.m. Yes. And the public's welcome to come. We discuss these contracts more in depth, along with other items. Any questions? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I have a warrants on the attachment for your approval. 5 human services warrants, 6 non-human services warrants, all totaling $3,598,830.88.
Questions? Motion to approve the warrants?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Thank you. Jill?
Was having a moment there, sorry. Evening. Commissioners, requesting your approval for the agenda attached on attachment E. This is the HR agenda. Transactions are routine in nature as well.
Questions? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Also prepared for you for informational purposes on attachment E1 is the row office HR agenda. Yeah, I would love to. Let me find it. The district attorney, I'm sorry, what are you referencing to?
Did he make some changes in his personnel?
He had some movement in his office, yes. That was under salary board. He has abolished and created some newer positions. A legal administrative assistant is what he created, abolishing the administrative assistant, and then also creating a lower level legal assistant to help with maintaining the office paperwork.
And this is going to help save some?
Right, this is also, he's cutting his expense down in his office by combining one position, a legal secretary and an administrative assistant, and then also creating a lower level secretary. So this will cut costs in his department, yes.
We appreciate him doing that for us.
Yes, we do.
That's why I'm referring to attention, I'm sorry. Okay. Any other questions?
Thank you.
Jason?
Commissioners, for your approval tonight, I have reviewed the reimbursement agreement with Vertical Bridge Development, which is a company that is constructing, we're looking to construct a cell phone tower in Plum Township. This is a standard agreement, that the county uses when we will incur engineering review fees, so that we can recoup those costs from the developer.
Questions? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
On favor, aye?
Aye.
I also have, asked your approval for a DEP 901A grant submission. This is for a project that we estimate would cost a total of $35,600 to study the feasibility and create a business plan for the construction of a recycling convenience center in Cranberry Township. We're asking DEC to provide $28,480 of funding towards that project. The county would provide $7,120 in staff time, printing costs, and cash match, which we already have on hand in a hauler account.
Do you want to explain why we're looking into this a little bit?
Right, well, we're looking into it as we've seen a dramatic increase in the amount of electronics and household hazardous waste collected. Several years ago, the state banned those items from the landfill, and the residents in the county had nowhere to take them. So we started with yearly collections, moved to quarterly collections, and now have a collection every 2 to 3 months because the demand continues to grow.
And then as far as the recyclables that most of the municipalities no longer have.
Right, and when those items were banned from the landfill, the municipalities started to see them show up in their recycling bins, which made it not cost effective to keep those bins and pay for the disposal of them. So this would allow residents a place where they could dispose of those recycling goods in a fenced in, you know, secure area.
Motion to approve the grant submission?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
On favor, aye?
Aye.
I also ask your approval of a contract modification for federal fiscal year 2015 CDBG contract. This project's in Rouseville Borough. They had originally requested $98,316 for a Main Street sewer line repair, but had an emergency water line break and are asking to divert that money to repair the break as they currently have an above ground line servicing residents with water.
Questions? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Next, Commissioners, I ask for your ratification of resolution number 2017-7 regarding funding for the Oil City Northside Urban Renewal Initiative. This is a local match commitment for the Redevelopment Assistance Capital Program grant that the Planning Commission wrote. This would commit the county to a $500,000 cash match and have the county certify that they will self-finance that cash match.
Questions? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
And finally, Commissioners, I ask for your approval for a fair realty transfer tax grant agreement with the Pennsylvania Housing Finance Authority for $60,000. This was a $250,000 grant request we submitted to PHFA and were awarded $60,000 of that to rehabilitate homes and demolish vacant blighted homes within the county.
Questions? Motion to ratify?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Favor, aye? Thank you, Jason. I should mention too, we meet with Jason in public workshop at the beginning of the morning of this meeting, 9 o'clock in the morning. So public's welcome to come. We discuss these things more in depth at that time. 2 mile run, Rich.
Commissioners, tonight for your approval and also recognition, I have the 2017 list of the Adopt a Pavilion project sponsors. This particular program was started back in about 2010, and we had two, three sponsors of the pavilions, and the whole idea was to not cost the county anything while allowing the businesses, the clubs, organizations to have free advertising so that we could do repair work, replace grills, all that kind of stuff with the pavilions. We have the most, we usually get 4 or 5. This year we have 10, the pavilions sponsored at the park. And Over the years, we've been able to now, we have 9 pavilions with brand new metal roofs that have been able to put on because of this program. 9 or 8 of these have been due to these sponsors. One was due to an Eagle Scout project, which you're going to hear a little bit more about with those guys later. And so this is the funds that came in, total roughly about $4,750, which will enable us to do at least 2 more pavilions this year. So I'm very pleased to have this, and what really is helping is the fact that the state or whatever passed that law that the clubs have to give back 85% of the money they make off the scratch-off tickets in the organization, so this is a great program for that. And we also will be soon be asking for sponsors. We have 2 new camping shelters coming into the campground, so we're going to be looking for sponsors for those things also. So I would request your approval for these pavilion sponsors. One thing I forgot to mention, what the pavilion sponsors have then is once they sponsor a pavilion, some of the organizations that have actually sponsored 2, they have signs that they're sponsored by, and they have the club or organization's name. They have because of their sponsoring, they can have a free family picnic at the park. And for example, the Franklin Moose, who sponsors the Fry Family Patio, has a Special Olympics every year, about the 3rd Saturday in June or July. And it's just amazing to watch those kids. It's fun to see. So these are the types of things, enable us, like I say, to keep the pavilions in under good repair, replace grills, replace tables, whatever we need to do. And again, it doesn't cost the county anything.
So have a motion to approve the sponsors.
So moved.
Second.
Second.
All in favor, aye.
Thank you. Just a quick update on the park activities and events. That recent storm, we were all about ready to open up for the season. When we got hit by the recent storm, you could not get in the park or out of the park. And after that storm hit about 3:20 in the afternoon. So the Oakland Township folks, I was temporarily playing traffic cop up there while they had their crews come in cutting the trees. And it was not fun. And the campground got hit pretty hard. We're getting ready to open up this Friday at the campground, and it's still, we have the trees down all over the park. Our trails are I couldn't even tell you how many trees are down on the trails in the park. It's we got hit pretty hard in several areas, so we're focusing on getting that cleaned up and focusing on getting that campground ready to open Friday. The number of events we had because of the rainy, cold weather, we had 2 events canceled this past weekend, the Oil Creek Fly Fishing Classic, and they haven't rescheduled it yet, but the Pennsylvania Equine Council canceled their ride Saturday. They're rescheduling it up for, I believe, June 3rd. We have the May 12th, the campground opening, Memorial Day boat races. We are totally out of campsites. With all the campsites in front of the Nature Lodge, all the 4 hookups are totally gone. So, it's going to be quite a crew coming in for that. June 3rd, the beach will open June 3rd. June 10th is the trail challenge. June 17th, the Oil City YMCA is having their triathlon. And let me see, we have the new camping shelter should be within the next couple weeks. I want to thank Jason and his staff, and also the Conservation District that just put in 2 new pollinator gardens, flower gardens in around the new the dock area. And I think that's about it.
Okay, thank you. County Administration, yes. Approval of co-location agreement with Zito. Zito Media has been working with us, helping to build out the fiber optic network we have throughout the Oil City, Franklin area. And they wanted a co-location agreement. They needed a site to put some of their electronics. So we agreed to allow them to place some electronics in one of the rooms beside the jail. In exchange for that, they're giving us
some fiber optic lines that would extend from where we're ending in Reno down to Oil City. So we would have a continuous loop throughout the, through the county between Oil City and Franklin. Have redundant, robust type of system and fiber optic network to be able to utilize for economic development. So, and Rich has reviewed this and made some changes and they've approved those changes.
Yes, they have.
Okay. Motion to approve the co-location agreement?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Approval agreement of sale with Raymond and Janet Beekner. This is the county in conjunction with the fiber optic network. We wanted to have some locations to do a business incubator type for high-tech businesses. And the Beekner, the building, the Corn Planter Square building they own in Oil City has been designated as an anchor building for the community there. And we agreed to purchase that utilizing our RACP money, which Jason can explain a little bit more maybe if anybody has questions. And we're going to put a business type of incubator for high-tech businesses on the top three floors. And the two bottom floors will be retail space. It'll be a public-private type of venture. And we are in discussions now with an entity who is looking at putting a brew pub type of establishment in the bottom two floors with some space for banquets. Thank you. So that's what the sale. And we want to thank and our appreciation to Ray and Jan for working with the county to make this possible and to save the building for downtown Oil City. You want to explain a little bit about the RACP money?
RACP funding is state redevelopment assistance capital funding that the Department of Community and Economic Development uses to spur job creation within the state. I don't know how much more.
That's someone else has questions. And the idea is to get the businesses established, get them started. Once they progress, then have them move out into other businesses, other locations, I'm sorry, downtown Oil City, some of the empty buildings now, especially the second floor type of spaces, but other, any space. And they would be connected into the fiber optic network. They can have connection into Chicago for their businesses. And that would continue on with our partnership with Zito or anyone else who wants another entity that would want to provide fiber, or provide high-speed broadband type of speeds for them. And being an anchor building, it opens up some funding for us. We believe we get enough funding to rehabilitate the building to where it needs to be. If not, the building was basically, it needs a lot of work. So, and we'll use this for purchasing the building, infrastructure in the building, and rehabilitating the building in conjunction, working with the private venture whenever we have that agreement in place. Anything else?
I guess the one little thing with the multi-mobile hub coming to complete on the one end of town, this on the other end of town, this will help separate that and hopefully draw growth in between as well. So it'll actually be a nice stimulus on both ends of town to help the whole Northside community hopefully grow to the future and change its demographics and dynamics and make a difference hopefully throughout the whole county.
Okay, motion to approve this then?
So moved.
For purchase, I should say. And second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Thank you. Reappointment Gary Shaw to the Northwest Workforce Development Board. Did you want to discuss this at all, Chip?
We have a representation on the WIP board, Workforce Development Board, and the appointment was up for Gary Shaw, and he was accepting to do it again.
Okay. Motion to approve.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Thank you. Resolution 2017-9 to create a County of Venango demolition fund. This was, and Rich can explain a little bit, the legislation gave us permission to add a fee onto transfers of deeds and
The legislation allows the county to create a dedicated fund to address blighted properties. The way to fund that is by a $10 fee on every deed that would be recorded. Effectively as of July 1 this year. So any deed after that would carry an additional $10 fee for blight.
Any questions or comments?
And it goes,
go ahead, Jim.
I was going to say, and it goes into separate funds specifically for demolition of blighted properties that meet a criteria of blight through the state.
This is will eventually be another source of income for the municipalities throughout Venango County that can draw on this fund. It'll be really, it's going through the county, but the land bank will be involved in designating who should get these funds, basically. Hopefully, it gives some of the smaller municipalities that don't have CDBG money or any source of real money to, for demolition, an ability to get rid of some of the blighted properties in their municipality.
And there are restrictions, pretty strict on the use of the monies and how it has to be reported and all, so. Any other comments? Motion to approve?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Thank you. Eagle Scout Recognition Proclamation, Vince.
This is a fun part of my job for the last 7 years. I can't say enough about young adults, I'll be politically correct, that take the time and effort to go completely through scouting and become an Eagle Scout. It's like 2% of the kids that go into scouting achieve that, the rank of Eagle. And I was fortunate enough that I'm an Eagle Scout, but it was back in the days when television went off at 11 o'clock and there were no cell phones and no video games. And for people to have that sense of commitment today to become an Eagle Scout, I have all the respect in the world for these kids. And there's five scouts that will attain the rank of Eagle Scout this year at Troop 111. Make sure that that's right. Like always, right. It's out in Cranberry. And I think that troop now has probably over 120 Eagle Scouts to its credit. So kudos to the team out there that is very, very committed to helping these young folks. And I'll tell you, folks, we don't find any Eagle Scouts next door, okay, in the jail. The five this year are Ian Best, Trevin Chichester, Andrew Holden, Dylan Schubert, and Austin Stevenson. I'll read the proclamation. Whereas democracy and liberty, hallmarks of the American heritage, are preserved through principles of responsible citizenship, and whereas it is incumbent on each successive generation to refine and perpetuate those principles of responsible citizenship, and whereas the recognition of organizations and individuals who strive to learn, educate, practice, and perpetuate those principles of responsible citizenship serve to properly reward the meritorious efforts while motivating others to seek greater levels of responsibility. Now there let be proclaimed by the Venango County Board of Commissioners that the following folks that I mentioned have honorably achieved the level of Eagle Scout and Boy Scouts of America. Further, let it be recognized and celebrated that the achievement in this is a culmination of individual, family, church, and community commitment, effort, and sacrifice. On behalf of themselves and a proud and grateful citizenry, the Venango County Board of Commissioners extend to those folks, all those contributing to their achievements, our congratulations, admiration, and respect.
Have a motion to approve the recognition proclamations.
So moved.
And second.
Second.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Thank you. Ratification agreement with Berkshire Flood Storage Solutions.
Commissioners, we're requesting your ratification of an agreement with Diversified Storage. Contract total is $2,452. That was for the tear down and hauling of a rolling storage system that we received from the Historical Society that we have taken out to the former Manor Building, and we are going to set it up for storage facilities out there at the Manor Building.
Questions? Motion to ratify the agreement?
So moved.
All in favor, aye?
Second.
I'm second, sorry?
Aye.
There we go. Thanks. I can't land myself. All right, ratification proclamation, Conservation District Week 2017. We proclaim the week of April 23rd to 30th as Conservation District Week honoring the great work accomplished by Pennsylvania's 66 conservation districts. Have a motion to approve?
So moved.
Ratify, I'm sorry, second?
Second.
All in favor, aye? Thank you. Ratification proclamation, Feldman Jewelers and Something Clever as the 2017 Business of the Year for Franklin Area Chamber.
Two weeks ago was the recognition dinner for the Franklin Chamber held in honor of Feldman Jewelers and Something Clever, the 2017 Business of the Year Award. Whereas Venango County has been fortunate to have two locally owned small businesses that are a welcome fixture in the downtown Franklin community. Whereas Feldman Jewelers and Something Clever are both owned and operated by Doug and Nikki Volrich, who have both been strong, giving, and supportive members of our local community for many years. Whereas the County of Venango recognizes the many charitable, civic, and philanthropic contributions made by Feldman Jewelers and Something Clever, and the county supports their involvement in helping sustain such charitable efforts within our community. Therefore, it be claimed that Venango County, through its Board of Commissioners, hereby honor the commitment of Feldman Jewelers and Something Clever. It was a nice award ceremony where you could hear Nikki speak about her trials, tribulations, and her start with Feldman Jewelers, and on a whim starting Something Clever, and how great they are for the downtown community, and all they do to give back. The example I give is Pillars of Communities as well as Keystones. They truly have a keystone business in the downtown Franklin area. And Doug and Nikki are true pillars of our community. With their hard work, they give back to many festivals. A lot of the stuff that goes on in Franklin, Doug and Nikki have their hand in, and it wouldn't be successful if it wasn't for them. And they do a lot of it without any sacrifice to their business or to themselves, and a lot of it's on their own without any benefit to them personally. So it's remarkable what they did and what they've created. So
have a motion to ratify this proclamation?
So moved.
And second?
Second.
All in favor, aye? Thank you. Any other business?
I just had one thing I forgot to mention. Saturday, May 13th from noon to 2, the new director, John Arwaite, who's new executive director of the Pennsylvania Fish and Boat Commission, will be at the Nature Lodge, and he's going to be talking about opportunities, laws, and regulations facing anglers, boaters, and aquatic resources in Pennsylvania, and they're also going to be demonstrating a boating safety, actually on a boat, run down to the new dock and stuff. So if anybody's interested, it's free, and they're going to have lunch and everything provided. So, and it's hosted by Representative Lee James.
Thank you. Kelly, comment? Yes, sir.
Thank you, Commissioners. I wanted to bring three little things to your attention.
Can I have your name, please?
Yeah. Aaron Bollinger. I was asked by Fred McMahon of the National Weather Service in Pittsburgh. He is the Severe Storms Coordinating Meteorologist to be a Weather Ready Nation Ambassador for Venango County. It's a new program that NOAA and the National Weather Service have to do a number of things in the planning stages of events, storm ready, lightning ready, all of these types of programs. The Weather Service now has mechanisms, planning guides, things that can help the events, fairs, anybody who needs these types of things to make us safer. As you know, it's kind of hard to go a week or two around here without some sort of a thunderstorm in the summer in prime event season. And as a musician myself, it's nice to know that there is a place to go when lightning starts hammering around and barrages of them coming at you. So these whole new set of federal initiatives for local municipalities. And as a way of bringing that out, I got back in touch with Fred and said, why don't we run a Skywarn training program as a way to kind of kick off Weather Ready Nation for Venango County. And we also set up a Facebook group. So there's now a place, if you're a Skywarn spotter, if you're any other type of amateur meteorologist in the region, we're kind of bringing this stuff together. There's nothing more exciting than reading a rain gauge every day. But as a way for people to get together who are in this and share and help the community in other ways, we wanted to bring this to your attention so you can help. Your emergency manager should be involved in this. Local fire departments should come to the Skywarn training. Many of them are. I think, Rick, here, you've been a Skywarn person since the 80s. And I wanted to recognize him for all he's been out there observing. The neat thing about the Facebook site that we set up, I think we had, what, 15 people were members,
yeah.
And then the severe weather hit last week. Suddenly, like 20 new people came in one day wanting to know what's going on. We were posting the radar reports and updates of where the storms were and things like that. So that's also a little hub now that the community can tap into. Farmers rely on the weather, and we all do. I wanted to get your contact information out there. Who knows? Some of these people that are volunteer weather people may help you clean up some of the trails where you've got trees down. So make sure, you know, left hand knows what right's doing, and maybe we can help each other out a little bit. But your staff here helped me a little bit, get a couple of flyers printed for you. That Skywarn training will be on the 26th of June, and we've got it set up to do at the Rockland Sportsman's Club. So it's a good spot in the county. People can get there easy enough. And Fred and the National Weather Service team will be coming up to serve five people in Skywarn. And for the last 2 years and for the last 6 months, I've actually been also the county coordinator for the Coco Ross weather program, which stands for Community Collaborative Rain, Snow, and Hail Network. So when there's severe storms in the area, we've got hail pads. We measure the hail, send it into the weather service. When there's rains, this gauge can take up to about 11 inches. If it's a downpour, or as you can see, it's fairly well used. It's been reporting for the last couple of years. Scientists, the National Weather Service, need that data for predicting floods, drought awareness, and things of that nature for the community. We would like to have two Coco Ross observers in every township, help us get numbers, you know, right. And some people just can't report. Maybe it's a week they're away. But it's nice to have a network in place. So we want to, you know, come to the meeting to help get the word out there that folks who have a spot to put a rain gauge, it's real simple. No rocket science involved, but all that data is getting monitored. And they can use that at the weather service to see, okay, the storms that came through, how much rain actually fell versus what we saw on the radar, what we think we saw. Just like Skywarn, ground truth to what they're seeing. So between Coco Ross and Skywarn, and of course the Weather Ready Nation initiative, which is a little bit more involved, but we can help your planning people with lightning awareness and safety and other things of that nature. So just wanted to make sure you all knew what was going on, and any way you can help get the word out to the volunteer departments, the other townships, whatnot, would be greatly appreciated. Thank you, Commissioners.
Thank you. Any other public comment at this time? Have a motion to adjourn the meeting?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor, aye.
Aye.
Thank you.